Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with the Z4 G5 from HP. Part of the high-end HP Z series workstation towers, the Z4 G5 is the best seller out of the bunch. I'm thinking probably a result of cost of the Z6 G5, Z8 G5, and the Z8 Fury G5 workstations. Still, it can tackle the same type of workloads addressed by the Z8 and Z6 workstations, maybe just a little slower. I'm talking design simulation, video editing, and a host of other applications spanning a variety of disciplines, including architecture and engineering and construction, product designers and engineers, plus entertainment, data scientists, and software developers. Shall we? With the new HP Z4 G5 workstation, I'm so glad they did away with the two motherboards supported on the Z4 G4 system. That just made it confusing to actually make a purchase, given the memory disparity and everything else. It wasn't like you could switch out the CPU if you changed your mind later on. In a nutshell, while both were called the Z4 G4, there were really two, the Z4 G4A and the Z4 G4B. Maybe they should have called it the Z4 WG4 and the Z4 XG4. That would have done it, but clearly I'm a few years too late. I mean, two entirely different motherboards, one for a Core X series CPU and the other supporting an Intel W-2100 series CPU. With the updated Z4 G5, there is only one processor family supported, and you definitely get a few more cores at up to 24 compared to only 18 on the G4, but only with the W series motherboard. Still, only up to 512 gigabytes of memory, just like the G4 version, but DDR5 memory in this case. General storage has nearly doubled compared to the Z4 G4 II at up to 92 terabytes. More on that in a bit. It's always fun to figure out how they actually arrive at that figure. Again, I'll give you a quick recap on the other systems before we get started on the Z4 G5 workstation. HP's other G5 workstations include the Z8 Fury G5, Z8 G5, and the Z6 G5. The Z8 Fury G5 workstation has a single socket supporting an Intel Xeon W3400 series CPU with up to 56 cores, with a memory capacity of up to 1 terabyte, up to 136 terabytes of storage, and up to 4 double-wide GPUs. The HP Z8 G5, without the Fury, is a dual-socket platform supporting Intel Xeon Scalable Gold or Silver CPUs for up to 64 cores total, up to 1 terabyte of memory, up to 136 terabytes of storage, and support for up to 2 high-end GPUs. With the Z6 G5, also a single-socket platform, it supports the Intel Xeon W3400 series CPUs with up to 36 cores, up to 1 terabyte of memory, up to 109 terabytes of storage, and up to 3 high-performance GPUs. All of these workstations support the 4th-generation Sapphire Rapid CPUs, whether the Intel Xeon W series or Intel Xeon Scalable series of CPUs. However, I am a little behind on the times. There is also a Z6 G5A platform too. Before we get to that, are you interested in the HP Z4 G5 workstation? Because if you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system that's listed or one that you can configure that's valued at $5,000 or more at itcreations.com. Just click that link to learn more. And when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. No cliffhangers. Did I not just say a little bit about the decision to have two platforms named the same with completely different CPUs and motherboards? Now we have the Z6 G5A with an AMD Ryzen Threadripper Pro 7000WX CPU with up to 96 cores, up to 1 terabyte of memory, up to 12 SSDs, and you can install up to 3 high-end GPUs. I mean, really? How about just calling this one the Z7 G5? I can imagine the conversation of management to the marketing team at HP. Maybe something like this. We purchased too many cases for the G4 system. R&D on these G5 systems cost a bundle too. Why don't we just use the same case for the G5 systems that we used for the G4? Wait, what? We've got to put something on the case. I mean, we've never even had an AMD Ryzen Threadripper Pro system. We've never even had a Z8 Fury G5 system before. I mean, how about we do a Z5 or Z7 and kind of round out the product line? Sounds complicated. I mean, what's the point? Oh, I don't know, maybe marketing differentiation of our products? You know, like defining a competitive advantage, offering a unique selling proposition, setting our products apart from the competition. Whatever, we're Hewlett Packard. Let marketing figure it out. They've got new coffee pods in the cafeteria. And now back to the HP Z4 G5 workstation. On the front of the system, an integrated handle, 2 media bays, and a control panel. And the control panel is available in 2 options, premium or entry. The entry control panel has a power on button, hard drive activity light, combo headphone microphone jack, USB Type A port with charging on the far left, and then three more Type A ports offering 5 gigabit per second data transfer rates, and a card reader. The premium control panel is just like that entry panel, except for the addition of some super duper speed USB ports. Two ports on the left are Type A with 5 gigabit per second data transfer rates, with that far left one still offering charging capabilities. The other two on the right are Type C ports offering 20 gigabit per second data transfer rates and USB power. As for the 5.25 inch media bays, only one is configurable from the factory. Both look like they could support a drive cage, but you still need a connector for the drive on the motherboard, and there is only one. That factory configurable media bay will accept a 3.5 inch drive cage supporting two 3.5 inch or 2.5 inch drives, or an M.2 drive cage that could support two M.2 hot swap drive caddies. Specifically, the crew ships module supports the M.2 drive bay and has an integrated lock for security. There is a 4-bay M.2 option, but that one is not compatible with the HP Z4 G5. The 4-bay M.2 option is only compatible with the Z8 Fury G5 or the Z6 G5 and the Z6 G5A. A dedicated connector on the system board connects a slim SAS cable to the crew ships module. After February 5th of 2024, HP will offer the ships module with a PCI 4.0 interface instead of the PCI 3.0 interface. Fan software, short for Front Accessible NVMe Storage, is pre-installed on all G5 workstations. It allows users to monitor usage, drive ejection, and RAID monitoring of the front accessible storage bay. With ships referring to secure high-performance storage, is it any wonder it was primarily developed for media and entertainment plus government and law enforcement applications? There are LEDs to indicate drive activity and status too. That media bay will also accept two optical drives. Moving on to the back of the system, another cutout at the top of the chassis for a handhold with power supply below that. There are several options for power supplies, including 1125 watts, 775 watts, and 525 watts. Definitely the 1125 watt option if you want to install dual 300 watt GPUs. It does have a self-test LED right next to the socket. Next, a power on button, audio headphone jack, remote interface port, HP Flex I/O port, which we will look at in a moment, and it's only available on select models, then a single RJ45 port for networking, six USB super speed Type A ports, and a bunch of PCI ports below. The remote interface port could enable a network access for a remote user over an encrypted channel. As an option, it will also support Thunderbolt 4, offering a high bandwidth at 40 gigabits per second, a single 10 gigabit Ethernet port, and two 2.5 gigabit Ethernet ports. A number of software utilities are supported on the system for performance, maintenance, troubleshooting, and security. The HP Performance Advisor will help you get the most out of the ISV software supported on the system by automatically adjusting the settings based on the hardware and software configuration. HP Anywhere is available in PCI-mounted card or externally mounted device. HP Anywhere provides remote access to the system from a single secure interface. It enables remote support and maintenance from anywhere you have an internet connection. The front crew ships modules also have their own front accessible NVMe storage, or FANS, software. FANS is a separate software utility to facilitate rapid ejection and general monitoring of the drives, including internal drives that may be part of a RAID with those mounted in the media bay. For documentation on all of that stuff, visit IT Creations, link below. This system can be ordered with Linux or Windows-based operating systems. If you experience problems, there is a maintenance and service guide which can help you with that. Also useful is the HP PC hardware diagnostics, of which there are three versions. One for Windows, one for the Unified Extensible Firmware Interface, or UEFI, and one a remote version of the UEFI version. Select models only. HP Sure Recover is built into the hardware and software and can help restore the system without installed recovery software. It is only available on select products. If you run a business and need security for a number of platforms, HP Wolf Pro Security to the rescue for Windows 10 or 11. More for ransomware and brute force attacks. The side cover has an optional lockable handle with a perforated section on the lower portion. Just inside, there is a removable PCIe retainer with two integrated fans. The optional front-mounted card guide also has an integrated fan. This allows for greater airflow for dual GPUs, with airflow being sucked in, traveling through the GPUs, and then directed out the back, courtesy of that gigantic fan above the PCIe slots. You can see the general layout is not quite as, what is the word I'm looking for? Fancy, as the Z8 Fury G5 or the Z8 G5. Those have another inner shell of lovely brushed aluminum cover plates. What really dominates the interior of the Z4 G5 is the memory cooler and vapor heatsink for the CPU. That heatsink extends almost the entire width of the chassis for maximal cooling area. Again, we have the blue markers here, and they're indicating removable components or hold downs. Supported processors from the Sapphire Rapids Intel Xeon W2400 series include those from the W3, W5, and W7 product families. Those offer a spread of cores from 6 at the bottom end, with the W32423 delivering 15 megabytes of L3 cache, to the W2495X at the top, offering 24 cores and 45 megabytes of L3 cache. For content creation, there are a lot of very favorable reviews from these processors. However, they do not offer integrated graphics, so you will need a graphics card. They all support hyper-threading technology for twice the number of virtual threads as physical cores. Under the memory module cooler, there are 8 DDR5 memory module slots. The CPU supports 4 memory channels for 2 DIMMs per channel. HP has limited this system to 512 gigabytes of memory, at least so far, while from Intel's datasheets, the CPUs will support up to 2 terabytes of DDR5 4800 ECC memory. Hopefully a refresh with support for more memories in the future, but don't hold your breath. Memory speed supported ranges from 4400 megahertz to 4800 megahertz, depending on the processor and memory configuration, with 2 DIMMs per channel taking memory speed down to 4400 megahertz. Some of the lower end CPUs will only support the 4400 megahertz speed. The CPU supports 64 PCIe 5.0 lanes. There is a single PCIe 5.0 by 16 slot, then there are 2 PCIe 4.0 by 16 slots, and 2 PCIe 4.0 by 4 slots, powered by the chipset. All are accessible from the rear of the chassis. 2 more PCIe 4.0 by 8 slots are for the internal M.2 drives. As I said before, the front media bay will accept 2 M.2 drives or 2 3.5-inch drives or 2 optical disk drives. Internally, just below that media bay, there are 2 3.5-inch drive bays. Those would connect to the SATA ports on the bottom right. 5 of those, by the way. Onboard RAID is supported via the CPU with RAIDs of 0, 1, 5, or 10. A VROC key can also be installed on the system board for NVMe RAID support of 0, 1, and 10. If you do install the optional M.2 drive cage in front, there is an NVMe connection for the slim SAS cable, adjacent to the memory slots. How do we get that 92 terabytes of storage? I think there are several ways to make this work, and I think the 92 terabytes is perhaps something that may change or is not really a hard value for storage. One solution includes a single 12 terabyte 3.5-inch drive in each of the media bays using a 3.5-inch drive cage, 2 more 12 terabyte 3.5-inch drives in the internal 3.5-inch drive carriers, 2 4 terabyte M.2 drives mounted in each of the slots on the system board, each is PCIe 4.0 by 8. It does seem like there is some extra bandwidth there, but let's move on. Next, 2 HP Z Turbo Quad drives, each with 4 4 terabyte M.2 drives. Those would be mounted in 2 of the x16 PCI slots at the bottom of the chassis for full bandwidth. That still leaves that PCIe 5.0 x16 slot for a double-wide high-performance GPU, and perhaps one of the x4 slots for Thunderbolt or Wi-Fi 6 plus Bluetooth 5.2 wireless card. Yay! Once again, a slew of video cards from NVIDIA, AMD, and Intel are supported, with the 300-watt NVIDIA RTX 6000 Ada at the top of the list. And you can install 2 of those each with 4 display ports. If you need more than that on a single card, the AMD Radeon Pro W6800 32GB has 6 display ports. I don't see any reason why the AMD Radeon Pro W7800 series won't work too. Not as many display ports on that one, but it will do 4 4K monitors or a single 12K monitor. Certainly there is more to the HP Z4 G5 story, and as often happens, the specs may get an upgrade at some point. I do hope you like this hardware review, overview, or whatever you want to call it. Click to subscribe to our channel, as I will be covering more high-end performance workstations and servers. If you're looking for the HP Z4 G5 or perhaps one of the other Z series workstations like the Z8 Fury G5 or the Z6 G5, then check out itcreations.com using one of the links below or that one right there. We also have the parts to fully configure your system. itcreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.